are going to perform the skill of IM injection. So I'm going to go over here to the EHR and I'm going to open up my patient's chart. Okay, now I'm going to go log into the computer. I'm going to find my patient. Okay, Morgan Brown. Okay, Morgan Brown, MR281199, no known allergies, date of birth, August 4th, 1970. Now I'm going to look for my order. I see here that today, 5:22 at 6:30 a.m., the doctor ordered a pneumococcal vaccine one time to be given IM, due today at 10 a.m. And now I'm going to go to the med cart to grab my supplies. I'm going to grab my medication. I need to grab a needle. With an IM injection, you want at least 1-inch to 1.5-inch needle. I have that here. I'll need a gauze pad, 2x2. Some alcohol, and of course my gloves. I'm also going to look up the medication in the drug book, see if there's any sensitivities or issues with giving it to this patient, though I do see that he has no known allergies. I see I got the pneumococcal vaccine. It can be given injection. Adults 50 and older and children age 2 and older that are at high risk, 0.5 mLs, given IM or sub-Q, but today we're going to give it IM. And that's about it. Okay, the only reason I would hold off on giving this vaccine would be if my patient had a fever or if they had an allergy to the actual vaccine. Okay. I'm going to take everything here. Okay, so I see here, I'm going to compare my medication to my physician's order. I have the pneumococcal vaccine, 0.5 milliliters per each dose. Expiration date is 2 of 2054, so we're good to go on that. I'm going to give this IM. It says IM or sub-Q. Again, it's ordered today to be given at 10 a.m., to my patient Morgan Brown, who has no known allergies and date of birth of August 4th, 1970. And I will do my documentation upon the administration of the medication. Now I'm going to prepare my medication. Scrub the top of the vial with some alcohol. Take my needle and then assemble this. I'm going to draw up air the same amount that I am to administer, a little bit over. So since I'm giving 0.5 mLs, I'm going to draw up just a little past 0.5, inject into the vial, inject my air. Draw up 0.5 or a little more to make sure that there's no bubbles. A few bubbles there. I'm going to get that air out. Okay. Then I'm going to do a one-hand scoop. to recap. Okay, now I'm ready to go to my patient's room, but I'm gonna do my third check. Again, I have the pneumococcal vaccine for Morgan Brown, MR281199. No known allergies, date of birth, August 4th, 1970. And I see he was ordered today, 5:22 at 6:30, the pneumococcal vaccine, one dose to be given IM today at 10 a.m. Expiration date is within, it expires 2/20/54, to be given IM or sub-Q. Now I'm going to go to the patient's room. Hi Morgan, it's Sarah, your nurse. I'm here to give you your pneumonia vaccine. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good.
Can you tell me your name and date of birth?
Morgan Brown, August 4th, 1970.
Okay, that's what I see here. All right, so your doctor ordered for you to get the pneumonia shot. I'm going to log in here. So today we're going to give this shot in your butt area. Okay, so let's see here. I have an order here for the pneumonia shot. It's due today at 10. Okay. Grab some gloves. I'm just going to bring your bed up here to a comfortable height. Okay. Now, Morgan, because I'm left-handed, I'm going to have you turn on your side so I can get at the butt area correctly. Now, there's the option we're going to do right now is the ventrogluteal area. Okay, so there are certain markings that you have to be able to do. You want to take the palm of your hand and you want to feel for the greater trochanter. Then you want your fingers up at the iliac crest. Okay, you want to position your hand like this. Then also remember, we're going to have to do what's called a Z-track, and that is for the medication administration, but also increased comfort on the patient's side. Now, because I'm left-handed, I want to inject with my left hand. You want to inject with your dominant hand. You have better control of your needle that way. Okay, so I have my markings here, just so you can see. So first I'm gonna scan the patient. Okay, now I'm going to scan the medication. I got to fill in my fields. So my dose is 0.5 mLs. And then I'm going to put in the comment here, given in right ventrogluteal. And then click submit. Okay, Morgan, have you turned there on your right side? I'm gonna clean the area, might be a little cold. Again, putting my palm on the greater trochanter, my fingers are at the iliac crest. I'm gonna clean my area. Then I'm going to Z-track. Remember, I'm left-handed, so I have to give my injection with the left hand. You want to inject at a 90 degree angle. Aspirate for 5 seconds. Make sure you get no blood return. If you do get blood return, you need to stop. I have no blood return, so I'm going to inject the medication. Okay. Hold that there. Remove. Engage my safety. I'm going to apply gauze. then go ahead and put my needle in the sharps box. Okay, Morgan, that's it. You might have some soreness for a day or so. I will come back and check on you, make sure you had no reaction, check the area for any redness or inflammation. I see you have your call light. I'm gonna go ahead and put your bed down and you call if you need anything, okay?
Okay.
Now I'm gonna log out. Grab my supplies. And Morgan, I'll be back to check on you or call me if you need anything. Now I'm going to demonstrate giving an IM injection in the deltoid. So what you're gonna do is you want to measure from the acronium process 3 finger widths down and then inject into the deltoid right below your 3rd finger. Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna do the same documentation we did before with the ventral gluteal. One other thing I wanna comment on, there is another muscle that we can inject IM that I'm not gonna demonstrate today, and that is the vastus lateralis. Okay, so Morgan, I'm gonna go ahead and scan you here. All right, I'm gonna scan my medication. Okay, now I'm gonna document. So the dose is 0.5 mLs. Then in the comment section, I'm gonna say, given in right deltoid. It's always important to document the site that you're giving the medication. Okay, go ahead and submit that. Okay, now I'm gonna go over here. All right, Morgan, I'm gonna give you your injection here. So remember, 3 finger widths down from the acromion process. Okay, now I'm gonna clean. Might be a little cold here, Morgan. Okay, now I'm gonna track over again using my left hand because I'm dominant. Going to poke at a 90 degree angle, a little poke. Aspirate, make sure we're getting no blood return. If we do have blood, we need to stop what we're doing, but I'm good, so I'm gonna go ahead and inject. Then I'm going to remove my needle, engage the safety, can release my hand. I'm gonna apply a 2x2, hold pressure there, put my needle in the sharps box. Okay, Morgan, we're all finished. Get your side rail back up here. Your arm will be sore for about a day or so. Don't be afraid to use it. It's actually better to move the arm rather than stay stiff. Got your collate. I'm gonna put your bed down. And I'll be back to check on you to make sure the site looks okay, make sure there's no reactions. You call me if you need anything sooner than that.
Okay.
Gonna wash my hands. And then always remember to log out of the computer before walking away. And that completes our skill of IM injection.